So I've presented several videos indicating that lifestyle factors are obviously very important in determining whether your brain is going to be healthy or that you are going to be at risk for a degenerative condition of your brain, things like Alzheimer's disease, for example. And it turns out that the reason that the high carbohydrate diet, the lack of physical exercise, gluten and other things that lead to inflammation are so important is because they tend to increase, as mentioned, inflammation, and the process of inflammation is tied in intimately with increasing what are called free radicals. So these are the two pillars, inflammation and the action of free radicals, that ultimately damage brain cells and actually lead to death of brain cells. Let's take a look. On this schematic, I've called your attention to the fact that inflammation increases free radicals, and ultimately that leads to the death of brain cells. And therefore, you might think, well, then I need to do everything I can to reduce this activity. And today, what I'd like to talk to you about is a notion of something called epigenetics. Now, epigenetics is a very empowering concept. Epigenetics means that our lifestyle choices can actually influence things like reducing inflammation, reducing the action of free radicals. We can change the expression of our DNA. Now, that's a very heady concept. Back when I was in medical school, I don't want to let you know how long ago that was, but it was quite a long time ago. We'll leave it at that. But we were told pretty much that our DNA was locked in a glass case and determined everything about us. We now understand that our lifestyle choices, the foods that we eat, the sleep that we get or we don't get, the type of nutrients that we may choose to take, change the expression of our DNA and can pave the way for health or disease. Let's take a look at this next slide. So now we understand that we can actually harvest this notion of epigenetics to reduce inflammation and increase antioxidant protection. Those, again, are the two leverage points that we want to look at in terms of protecting the brain. Now, one very important epigenetic factor to consider is there is a pathway called Nrf2. If we activate this gene pathway called Nrf2, it reduces inflammation and it improves antioxidant function. And on these next images, you'll see that many things that we can choose to do will turn on the Nrf2 pathway. This will increase the body's production of antioxidants, decrease inflammation, and in addition, an added benefit, it will increase the body's ability to detoxify. So getting aerobic exercise, reducing our caloric consumption, using the herb like turmeric or curcumin, green tea extract, resveratrol, a supplement, broccoli, garlic, and DHA all work through this pathway, amplifying Nrf2 activity and turning on those very brain protective actions of detoxification, reducing inflammation, and enhancing the body's own ability to produce its own antioxidants. So important to understand that we can control our genetic destiny based upon the foods we eat, the supplements we take, the physical exercise we get, even the rest that we get. Very powerful concept, epigenetics. I'm Dr. David Perlmutter.